I get on my back for a little bit? Okay, I'm not gonna hold you.
I don't want to see a bite.
Is this stuff for fish? Thank you.
generally improving our quality of life through hard work and innovation. But over the last century, human activities have been releasing greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, and the Earth has been heating up. The warming has been especially obvious in recent decades, and carbon dioxide levels are now high enough to cause a runaway greenhouse effect, with clear global impacts. Sea levels are rising, storms are becoming more intense, and coral reefs are suffering as the oceans warm and become more acidic. Humanity has released so much greenhouse gas that more warming is inevitable. But there are many ways we can reduce our emissions. Some solutions involve technology, education, and training. Others are based on pricing, laws, and policies. In Canada, climate change impacts include reduced polar ice, melting permafrost, extreme weather, increased risk of droughts and floods, and the fires and health issues associated with hotter summers. Saskatchewan accounts for about 10% of Canada's emissions, which are a small fraction of the global total. But our per capita emissions are more than double the national average due to our winters, the nature of our economy, and our small population. Fortunately, Saskatchewan has an abundance of low-emission options, such as uranium, powerful rivers for hydro, and lots of potential for wind, solar, geothermal, and biomass. The prairies are starting to see a range of climate change impacts, especially around water. Our major rivers are all fed by Rocky Mountain glaciers, which are shrinking. And it's not just the source of our water that's being lost. Some of this meltwater is draining into groundwater aquifers, which are increasingly impacted by surface pollution, mining, fracking, and domestic uses. Although much of the earth is covered in water, less than 3% of it is fresh, and less than 1% is readily available. The fresh water we use is replenished by the water cycle, but almost half the world population lacks access to safe supplies, and the demand is growing. Agriculture is by far the biggest user, taking 70% of the global supply each year. To meet this demand, many of the world's rivers are now controlled by dams, with new ones being built every year. These dams prevent flooding and generate power, but they can also impact fish migrations and the health of river deltas. Canada has about 20% of the world's fresh water, but less than half of it is renewable, and the rest is frozen, underground, or in remote northern lakes and rivers. Canadians also consume up to 300 liters of fresh water every day for drinking and other activities. And it takes a lot more to produce our goods and services. It can take 200 liters to produce one egg, over 3,300 liters for a liter of milk, and over 15,000 liters for a kilogram of beef. When this hidden water is accounted for, the annual water footprint of the average Canadian would almost fill an Olympic swimming pool, and almost all of this water comes from local sources. Canada has taken a number of steps to protect fresh water, such as banning phosphate detergents, upgrading sewage treatment, reducing toxic chemicals, and adopting environmental farming practices. On the prairies, good water management has always been vital and will be key in adapting to climate change. By making mindful choices around water use and the products we consume, each of us can help to conserve and maintain a healthy water supply. what steps can you take in the next month to do your part?